Hello, my dear students. How are you all? I hope writing your first Visual Basic program. In this section, you will be writing your first program in Visual Basic. Writing any VB6 program is a 5-step process. How many steps? There are 5-step process as follows. Step 1 is creating the user interface for the program. Second step, setting the properties for each object in the user interface. Third one, writing the program code. Fourth one, saving and running the program. And last step is building an executable file. हमें Visual Basic में जो program write down करना है, उसके 5 steps है. कौन कौन से? फर्स्ट हम हमारा यूजर इंटरफेस क्रिएट करेंगे, देन आफ्टर यूजर इंटरफेस में जो जो ऑब्जेक्ट्स हमने यूज किए हैं उनकी प्रॉपर्टीज सेट करेंगे, देन आफ्टर हम हमारा कोड राइट डाउन करेंगे, देन आफ्टर हमारा प्रोग्राम सेव एंड रन करेंगे, एंड लास्ट हम हमारे प्रोग्राम की एग्जीक्यूटेबल फाइल बिल्ड करेंगे. ओके, नाउ create a simple game in VB6. The objective of the game is to simulate rolling of a playing die by generating a number in the range 1 to 6 and show the face of die with 6 dots. If the virtual die thrown resulted in 6, also play the beep sound when this happens. यहाँ पर हम एक die game create करेंगे, उसमें रैंडमली 1 to 6 नंबर हाँ जनरेट होंगे, और जब 6 नंबर होगा तब हमें 6 डॉट्स उसमें विजिबल होंगे और एक बीप साउंड प्ले होगा. ओके, थस अवर प्रोग्राम शुड डू द फॉलोइंग. फर्स्ट स्टेप, प्रोवाइड अ यूजर इंटरफेस विथ अ लेबल शोइंग वेलकम मैसेज. Thereafter, two buttons named play dice and game. A label to display the outcome number turned up and image object for displaying the image of a die with 6 dots. हमारे प्रोग्राम में हमें क्या क्या रिक्वायर है? हमें एक लेबल जिसमें वेलकम मैसेज होगा, देन आफ्टर टू बटन्स जिसमें एक है प्ले डाइस का एंड सेकेंड वन एंड गेम का, एंड थर्ड लेबल फॉर द आउटकम नंबर एंड वन इमेज द डिस्प्ले द इमेज ऑफ डाई विथ 6 डॉट्स. ओके, देन आफ्टर पिक अ रैंडम नंबर 1 to 6 एंड डिस्प्ले देम व्हेन द यूजर क्लिक्स प्ले डाइस बटन. डिस्प्ले अ डाई शोइंग 6 ऑन द फेस and sound beep if the number 6 appears in the label above it. Terminate when the end game button is. Before you start building the interface, search over internet and download any image of die showing 6 on the face. You can also draw it on your own using paint. You will need this image to be placed on the interface. Okay, हमारा प्रोग्राम स्टार्ट करने से पहले हम एक इमेज डाई की डाउनलोड कर लेंगे या फिर हम पेंट में अपने आप वो इमेज ड्रॉ कर लेंगे. ओके, और उसे हमारे इंटरफेस पर प्लेस कर देंगे. नाउ क्रिएटिंग द यूजर इंटरफेस. The steps given below will help you to create a user interface. For creating the user interface, you will have to use the toolbox. First, on the file menu, click the new project command. Then after, click OK to create a standard 32-bit Visual Basic application. Drag the lower right corner of the form window to increase the size of the form. Notice that as you enlarge the form, the scroll bars appear in the project window. Figure 7. Note that there are two windows here. The inner one is called the form window and the outer one is the project window, you have to increase the size of the form window and note that of the project window. Okay, the form is now ready to get the controls from the toolbox. We will include the following on this form. First hum include karenge to command button controls, then after two label control and one image control. Okay, see here we added this all controls, two labels, two buttons and one image control. Remember that there are two ways to get the control over the form, as we already learned. Here we use the second method. Your screen should look as follows. Now you are ready to customize your interface by setting a few properties. Setting the properties. You can change the properties by selecting objects on the form and changing their setting in the properties window. Let us start setting the properties in this program by changing the caption setting for the two command buttons. Set the command button properties. First, click on command button 1 on the form. The button gets surrounded by selection handles. जब हम कमांड 1 को हमारे फॉर्म में से सिलेक्ट करेंगे तो बटन सराउंडेड बाय सिलेक्शन हैंडल, इट मींस कि बटन के अराउंड हमें सिलेक्शन हैंडल डिस्प्ले होंगे. डबल क्लिक ऑन द प्रॉपर्टी विंडोज टाइटल बार. द प्रॉपर्टी विंडो गेट एनलार्ज टू फुल साइज. The property window lists the setting for the first command button. Double click on the caption property in the left column of the property window. The current caption setting command 1 gets highlighted in the second column. Type play dice and press enter. The caption property changed to play dice in the property window and on the form. Now change the caption of the second button to end game like as first command button. Then after click command button 2, the second command button on the form, and change the caption to the end game and press enter. The caption property changes to end game in the property window and on the form. Next, double click on the font property and use the font dialog box to change the font to Comic Sans, style as bold and size to 18. Then after click OK. Enlarge the buttons if necessary. See here, caption of buttons are changed. Okay. Double click on the title bar of property window so that it returns to its original location with change caption of the command buttons and property window returning to its original location. Okay. Now we will set the properties for the label. Setting the label properties. Click on the first label object on the form. Change the caption property to welcome to the game of dice. Double click on the font property and use the font dialog box to change the font to impact style as regular and size to 18. Then after OK. Next, double click on four color property in the property window. A system tab and palette tab appear in a dialog box. The system tab will display the current colors used in the user interface, and the black tab allow picking a new color from the interface. Click the black tab and then click the desired color. The text take the selected color. Okay, यहाँ पर हमने क्या किया, हमारे label का caption change किया और जो हमने new caption दिया उसका फोर कलर, इट मींस की फॉन्ट कलर चेंज किया. ओके, सेटिंग द नंबर लेबल प्रॉपर्टीज. Now you will set the properties for the label which will display the number rolled. The label 2 will show the random number generated by the program. Click on the alignment property and then click the down arrow that appears to the right. The list box drops open and a list of alignment options appear. Select the two center option. The alignment property for each of the selected label changes to center. Click on the image box object on the then after. Now you are ready to set the properties of the last object. Sorry, it's repeated. Click on the image box object on the form. Then after, click the stretch property in the property window. Then after, click down arrow and select true. Setting stretch to true before you open the graphics will enable Visual Basic to resize the graphics to the exact dimension of the image box. Double click the picture property in the property window. The load picture dialog box appears. Using it, browse to the location of your picture and load it on the form. Resize a bit if required to make the picture align to rest of the controls. Finally, click on the visible property and in its drop-down list box, select false. This selection of to false will ensure that dice is not visible when the program starts. Your complicated form should be like the following figure 15. Then after writing the code. Now you are ready to write the code for the game program. The advantage of using Visual Basic is that most objects get automatically programmed when you create them and set their properties. Thus, they do not require any additional programming. The only program that is to be written is the one which generates random number from 1 to 6. For this, you will have to write the computing logic on your own. First code is written in the code window. It is a special window in the programming environment that you will use to enter and edit Visual Basic program statement. The programming code is written for only two command buttons on the form, for play dice and end game. Code for the end game button, the step listed below will help you to code both the command button. Let us start with a simple code of ending the program by coding the end game command button. First, double click on the end game command button on the form. The code window appears with the following code lines: private sub command 2 underscore click and end sub. All you need to do is to write and between the two code lines. Private sub command 2 underscore click and end sub in between and statement. Okay. See the figure 16. Note that as you type the statement, the letters appear in black in the code window. When you press down arrow key or press enter, the program statement turns blue, indicating that Visual Basic recognizes it as a valid statement or keyword in the program. We use the program statement and end to stop your program and remove it from the screen. Okay. See figure 16 code window along with the keyword end. Now that you have written the code associated with the end game button, you will write the code for the play dice button. This program will have several statements and give you an opportunity to learn more about the program syntax and styles. Code for the play dice button. Minimize the existing code window from the screen. Then after, double click on the play dice command button. The procedure associated with play dice, that is command 1 button, appears above the procedure for the end game command 2 button. Type the program line as shown below between the private sub and end sub statements, pressing enter. After each line, you make a mistake identified by red type, delete the incorrect statement and try again. Okay, now let's see the code. Image 1 dot visible is equal to false, hide dice. Label 2 dot caption is equal to integer in bracket random multiply by 6 plus 1. Here random integer from 1 to 6. If caption is 6, display the image of the die and babe. If label 2 dot caption is equal to 6, then image 1 dot visible true and beep sound. Then after and if, यहाँ पर प्रोग्राम का कोड क्या है? First image 1 dot visible हमने false किया है. Then after हमारे label 2 में हमें 1 to 6 random number मिलेंगे. Okay? Then after if condition, अगर label 2 के caption में हमें number 6 मिला, then image 1 dot visible is equal to true and beep sound. Then after and condition. Okay, after completion, the code window should look like the one shown in figure 17. Understanding the code. Before we proceed to save the program code, it is important to understand what has been coded. The first line of code is image 1 dot visible is equal to false. It means hide image of. Then after second line हमने क्या write down की? Just go through this and read it once. Then after saving the program, now that you have completed writing the code, it should be saved. Visual Basic save your form's code and objects in the file and the packing list of project's components in another file. Note that the project components are listed in the project window. You can use these components individually in other programming project by using add file command on the project menu. Okay, here it is save as dialog box. To save a program in Visual Basic, click on save project as on the file menu or click the save project button on the toolbox. Then after, type the file name as diceform and press enter. The form is saved under the name dice.frm. Next to appear is the save project as dialog box. Give the name as dice game and press enter like is figure 19. Before exiting out of saving procedure, Visual Basic may ask if you wish to add project to save source code. Click on no. If you say yes, this program will be saved with a password and will operate only if the password is provided. Okay, then after running the program, Congratulations, you are now ready to run your first program in VB6. To run VB6 program, you can either click on Start button on the Run menu or click on the Start button in the toolbar or press F5 key. The program now runs 20. See the figure? From Run menu, click on Start button or press F5 key. Click on Play Dice button. The program picks a random number from 1 to 6 and display in the label in the form. Keep clicking on the Play Dice button till the label display number 6. The moment 6 appears, the image of the die displaying 6 on the face appears along with a beep or chim sound. Okay, figure 22. Here, see in figure 21. Random display of numbers. Here number is 5. And see figure 22. It is number 6. So here we can see the image of die. Environment. Okay, on the desktop, double click on the dice game icon. The executable version now runs. You can play as before by clicking Play Dice button.